Investors, including hoteliers, large, small and medium-sized enterprises and various tourism service providers are among those who say their activities have been weakened by the COVID-19 pandemic. As soon as a fund was set up to rehabilitate their economy devastated by the pandemic, some responded immediately. With the airport and borders closed, tourism and hotel activities were all put at a standstill. So about the fund that the government set up, we have asked for it in the banks we were already working with. They have not written to us back, but we hope that they will help us in that recovery. It's been a week since we last heard from them. Regarding the government's recovery fund, especially for hotels, it is a good thing. The government has helped us a lot, and we are happy that the funding will not solve all our problems, but will reduce it. We are working with banks that we usually use to work within our businesses, and we hope to meet all the requirements. The Tourism Chamber in the Private Sector Federation says that there are about 1,000 people and that they are allowed to apply for a loan from the fund, which was launched by the government of Rwanda in June. The investors say that although the money has been transferred to the financial institutions they work with, they have not yet received it because of the available long process. Many have shown us that they are just happy with this, but that there are still many things that need to be understood by them before they go for that money. Almost all of the applicants are complaining about the delay. Some will tell you that I have gone to the bank and they sent me this and that, and they are asking me this again. So even the financial institutions that provide the money need information concerning our traders or members, of which they also need to understand to meet the requirements. For some of the financial institutions through which this money has been transferred, it is clear that despite the large number of registrants applying for these loans, it requires a thorough audit to see if they meet the requirements. Emmanuel Bahizi, the head of corporate banking at the Bank of Kigali, says that they have already received 600 people applying for the loan of the fund and that others are still registering despite the fact that no one has received the money yet. You have to show us proof of no unpaid government tax and show us receipts for the previous year. There is a certificate provided by the Rwanda Revenue Authority that backs that up. You then get to show us what you plan to use the money for review. We check with the loan you already have in Bank of Kigali and how you repaid it before the pandemic. To this day, we haven't given it to anyone, but the plan has started. And now we have a list we have given to BNR, and not so long, we shall be giving out this money to these institutions for development. The deputy governor of the Central Bank of Rwanda, Dr. Nsanzabaganwa Monique, explains the extent of the disbursement. Sincerely, this is not money that will be directly transferred to the company's accounts, but it is to help them ease up things for them with the banks they usually work with in their businesses. So currently on the list, there are hotels that have already met all the requirements. The Economic Recovery Fund started with 100 billion Rwandan francs, of which 50 billion will be for hotels, 30 billion for large businesses, 15 billion for medium enterprises, and 1 billion Rwandan francs to be shared among small companies, not forgetting SACCOs that were allocated to billion. Innocent Mugabo, RTV News, Kigali.